Hello everyone. Narcissist Free almost here, and as I mentioned in my update video, I'll be starting a new video series on Otto Kernberg's work, namely Aggression and Pathology, specifically Narcissistic Personality Disorder and Borderline Personality Disorder. First, I want to mention a little bit about Dr. Kernberg. Currently, he is a training and supervising analyst at the Columbia University Center for Psychiatric Training and Research, professor of psychiatry at Cornell University Medical College, and director of the Institute for Personality Disorders at the New York Hospital, Cornell Medical Center, Western Division. He is author of many books, including Love Relation, Normality and Pathology, and Severe Personality Disorders, Psychotherapeutic Strategies, to name a few. To say this guy is qualified is an understatement, and it is my pleasure to bring you his work on aggression in personality disorders. That said, I'll be covering the drive of aggression, and its correlates, namely, rage and hatred, where it begins and how it presents in the person with a personality disorder. Kernberg writes that hatred is a core affect of severe psychopathological conditions, perversions, and functional psychosis. Hatred derives from rage, the primary effect around which the drive of aggression clusters in severe psychopathology. Hatred may evolve into overwhelming dominance directed against the self, as well as at others. It is a complex effect that may become the major component of the aggressive drive, overshadowing other universally present aggressive effects such as envy or disgust. So let's stop briefly for a moment and distinguish between drives and instincts. Freud clearly differentiated drives from instincts, where he saw drives as supraordinate, they were constant rather than intermittent sources of motivation. Instincts are considered biological, inherited and intermittent in that they are activated by physiological and/or environmental stimulation. Libido is a drive, and hunger is an instinct. Freud's conception of drives as on the boundary between physical and mental, as psychic processes rooted in biology. He proposed that the only way we can know about drives is through their psychic representatives, ideas and affects. Here, the focus, for the most part, is on the developmental vicissitudes of rage, which lead to the dominance of hatred in certain people with severe character pathology, resulting in hatred as an overriding effect. Understanding its origins in infant research, the early appearance of rage as an affect, and its primordial function is to eliminate a source of pain or irritation. A later developmental function of rage is to eliminate an obstacle of gratification, the original biological function of rage signaling to the caregiver to get rid of the irritant, now becomes a more focused appeal to the caregiver to restore a desired state of gratification. In this figure is the intrapsychic structure of the borderline. Recall how they see things in part objects, never having achieved a fully integrated psyche, and therefore things and people become all good or all bad, making them enormously susceptible to frustrations. So, in terms of object relations, rage comes to signify both activation of an all-bad object relation and the wish to eliminate it and restore it to an all-good one. At a still later developmental stage, rage reactions may function as last-ditch efforts to restore a sense of autonomy in the face of highly frustrating situations, unconsciously perceived or threatening activation of all-bad, persecutory object relationships. Remember where this persecutory object comes from? This would have been something that needed to be resolved in the paranoid schizoid position of development, where the infant, fearing his fantasies of destroying both good and bad aspects of his object or mother, will cause the object to retaliate in kind. A violent assertion of will functions to restore a state of narcissistic equilibrium, and this act of self-assertion represents an unconscious identification with an idealized good object. In a clinical setting, activation of aggression as rage, where irritation is a mild aggressive effect that signals the potential for rage reactions and, in chronic forms, presents as irritability. Anger is a more intense effect than irritation, usually more differentiated in its cognitive and in the nature of the object relationship activated. A full-fledged rage reaction, and its overwhelming nature, its diffuseness, its blurring of specific cognitive contents and corresponding object relations may convey the erroneous idea that rage is a pure primitive affect. However, and pay close attention here, the analysis of rage reactions, as of other intense affect states, always reveals underlying conscious and unconscious fantasy that includes a specific relation between an aspect of the self and an aspect of a significant other. Again, in clinical settings, the intensity of aggressive affects, whether irritation, anger, or rage, correlates roughly with their psychological function. To assert autonomy, to eliminate an obstacle or barrier to a desired degree of satisfaction, or destroy a source of profound pain or frustration. But the psychopathology of aggression is not limited to the intensity and frequency of rage attacks. The most severe and dominant of the effects together constitute aggression as a drive, is the complex or elaborated affect of hatred. As one moves from the transference developments of the neurotic personality organization to those of people with borderline personality organization, particularly those with severe narcissistic personality pathology and antisocial features, you are increasingly faced, not only with rage attacks, but with hatred, which emerges along with certain typical secondary characterological expressions of, and defenses against awareness of this effect. Now, as you can see, hatred is a complex aggressive affect. Compared to the acuteness of rage reactions and the easily varying cognitive aspects of anger and rage, the cognitive aspect of hatred is chronic and stable. Hatred also presents with characterological anchoring that includes powerful rationalizations and corresponding distortions of ego and superego functioning. Where characterological is describing a person with a personality disorder, at anchoring being a cognitive bias that describes the common human tendency to rely too heavily on the first piece of information offered, the anchor, when making decisions. Also, to say that the ego is distorted is to simply say that the mental apparatus is in a state of disordered function. That said, the primary aim, when being consumed by hatred, is to destroy its object, a specific object of unconscious fantasy, and this object's conscious derivatives. The object is at the bottom both needed and desired, and its destruction is equally needed and desired. Understanding this paradox is at the center of psychoanalytic investigation of this effect. Note, hatred is not always pathological as a response to an objective real danger or psychological destruction, a threat to survival of oneself and those one loves. Hatred is a normal elaboration of rage aimed to eliminate danger. But, unconscious motivations usually enter and intensify hatred, as in the search for revenge. When it is a chronic characterological predisposition, hatred always reflects the psychopathology of aggression. Pretty good stuff, huh? Next video will be a continuation of hatred, and its different manifestations, particularly in the narcissist and borderline. So if you like that, be sure to give a thumbs up, comment and subscribe. If you like, you can follow me on Facebook at NarcissistFreeAlmost, and on Instagram at Clumber_Lover with a U. And, as always, all my love and gratitude, and I do hope you're living peace of mind narcissist free. I know I am.